every one of you for being here and leading the charge for an America and a world that works for all of us. And I want to agree with everything that Adamu said and everything that Sherry said and agree with all of their thank yous. I want to reiterate them and just add to that a big thank you to Lynn Sturpee, who's been running the show. Out there now on the TV, and when I walked to the airport, when I arrived and walked up to the curbside check-in, and I gave to the brothers who were manning the curbside check-in, I gave them my ID card, and they said to me, "Are you the Jill Stein?"
I knew they had heard the voice of Cornell West speaking to the broad community that has not been able to hear our message before.
So thank you, brother. I am so inspired to have religion on this campaign. And I also am so honored to run along with the inspired state and local candidates who are also running for office and bringing our message of people planning peace. Please stand. Stand if you are running for office so we can thank you and recognize you for carrying this fight into our communities. We are in this together. And I just want to recognize that things have been forever changed. On the day that Bernie Sanders endorsed Hillary Clinton, the floodgates opened in our campaign to more volunteers, more ballot access drivers, more funding. We are a different campaign than we have ever been in history for having joined forces with you. It is such an honor to be your candidate in this historic moment of unprecedented crisis and unstoppable momentum for transformational change. We have not only a historic opportunity, we have a historic responsibility to be the agents of that transformational change. As Martin Luther King said, the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. I know that arc is bending in us and through us right now. We are the actors in something that is much bigger than us as we struggle for justice, peace, community, and healing together. That arc of justice is moving through us as we mobilize to ensure that every Black life matters and we end violent policing and broken windows policing. As the Frisco Five and the Millions March New York City just achieved by moving out the leadership of their police department that had overseen broken windows policing. They are turning the tide in this crisis of racist policing. That arc of justice is moving through us as we sit in and as we lock down to stop fracking pipelines and fossil fuel bomb trains and coal and LNG export terminals and all manner of poisonous fossil fuel and nuclear infrastructure. That arc of justice was moving through us in Philadelphia like I have never seen. In the city of brotherly love, it was overrun by love in the streets, even inside of the DNC, as the Sanders campaign broke away from that corrupt and backstabbing DNC. And the Bernie or Bust movement that is here today. And I want to thank Yane Ndogo in particular. Yane, give a wave wherever you are, for helping us move to that higher place together.
together where we cannot be stopped.
Thank you,
sister. We moved together in Philadelphia, and we merged our campaigns in rally after rally, growing stronger by the hour. The power of this movement was clear, especially during our power rally at FDR Park. Who was there?
Raise your hand if you were there.
Because it was not only us, and it was a sea of people as far as my eye could see, when nature erupted in thunder and lightning to say there is a big change coming. And as the heavens opened up and it poured down around us, we sought shelter because we were there inside of this little lightning rod of a tent out in the middle of this park, and the police said, hurry up, go underneath that underpass. So we just moved the rally, and we continued under the underpass in the lightning and the thunder and the rain because we cannot be stopped. People those votes can go, and you are looking at it. It is the Stein Baraka campaign. It's about time we bailed out the students, we bailed out the crooks on Wall Street who crashed the economy with their waste, fraud, and abuse. It's time to bail out some of the key victims of that abuse, a generation of young people.
Education.
classroom that they deserve. That is small classroom sizes. This is not rocket science about how to educate kids. We will provide them with enriched curriculum. That means music and arts and recreation and community engagement. We will do for our kids what the advocates and leaders of so-called education reform are doing for their kids. They are not sending their kids to schools with high-stakes testing. A couple other quick mentions because we're almost out of time. We will create a welcoming path to citizenship for our immigrant residents who are leading the way for just and sustainable and prosperous communities. We are all immigrants on this bus. If you were not brought here on a slave ship or your land was not stolen, everyone else here is an immigrant. And we will stop. We will stop the deportations. We will stop the deportations, the detentions, and the night raids, which are a national scandal, while the Republicans have become the party of hate and fear-mongering. The Democrats are the party of deportation, detention, and night raids. We are the alternative for a just and welcoming path to citizenship. Another thing we will do to fix the immigration crisis is to stop causing it in the first place. We say to Donald Trump, we don't need no friggin' wall, we just gotta stop invading other countries. So that all cases of death in the custody of police are investigated. Not just the few that get a special thumbs up from Washington and the Department of Justice. And we call for a Truth and Reconciliation Commission so we can get to the bottom of this crisis of racism and to provide reparations to acknowledge the enormous debt owed to the African American community for the unimaginable price that they paid in building this country and sustaining our economy for generations while they were denied dignity and freedom.
No more! No more! No more!
that have not made us safer, that have only increased the terrorist threat, that have created failed states, and have created mass refugee migrations that are tearing apart the Middle East and Europe.
We say no to those wars. We call for a new.
It's just unthinkable that they want to do more of this same catastrophically failed policy, and that's why we need to be on the debate stage
so we can tell the truth about this.
Remember, when they try to tell you you are powerless, We are saying no to the lesser evil and yes to the greater good, because we are not only deciding what kind of a world we will have in this election, we are deciding whether we will have a world or not going forward into the future. The day of reckoning is coming closer and closer on climate change. We are told that there will be a civilization-ending development in the form of massive sea level rise as soon as 2050. Anybody plan to be here in 2050? I think a few of us do, myself included. So we cannot wait, because we have to act now if we want to stop that sea level rise from happening in 2050. We need to declare a state of emergency right now and undertake a wartime scale mobilization to create those 20 million jobs and create that 100% clean energy now. We have a crisis in nuclear weapons, and again, thanks very much to the Democrats. Bill Clinton, who removed us from the anti-ballistic missile treaty framework for nuclear disarmament, and then Barack Obama, who created a $1 trillion budget for us to spend on a new generation of nuclear weapons and modes of delivery. So on the count of climate, on the count of nuclear weapons and this insane nuclear arms race that we are once again headlong plunging into, and on the count of these endless and expanding wars that are blowing back at us all around the world, we cannot afford to sit this one out. The lesser evil is a losing strategy because people stop coming out to vote for lesser evil politicians throwing them under the bus. So the Republicans will win anyhow. And to look at Donald Trump does not stand alone. Donald Trump is about the rise of right-wing extremism, not only in this country, but in Europe. And as Bernie Sanders himself so often said, the only solution to the likes of Donald Trump is a truly radical, progressive agenda that restores our needs and ends the economic misery that promotes the kinds of demagogues we are seeing in Donald Trump. We are the ones we've been waiting for. Hillary Clinton is the problem. She is not the solution to Donald Trump. We are the solution. We are the ones we've been waiting for. This is our moment. Together, we do have the power to create an America and a world that works for all of us. The power to create that world is not just in our hopes, it is not just in our dreams, right here and now, it's in our hands. We will make this happen together. We are unstoppable. Thank you.